Wisconsin Sheriff David Clark, who this week warned that enforcing any gun laws that would deprive Americans of the right to bear arms could lead to a second American Revolution. Sheriff, you've been very vocal, and by the way, I absolutely agree with you. If you wait for 911, you know, then shame on you. You've got to arm yourself and defend yourself once you educate yourself. Well, what's this whole idea of a second revolution? Where's that coming from?
Well, the question was, would I participate in assisting the feds coming into states and going into homes and taking everybody's gun away? And I said, I would not be a part of something like that. And I said, one of the reasons is I wouldn't want to get shot, because the American people are only going to put up with so much before they push back. And I said, if the feds tried to do that, disarm this country, I said, you would see an uprising and maybe a version of the second American Revolution because of that. Just read the Declaration of Independence. You know, it's right in there. So it was talking about the feds coming in and going into homes. Forcing their way into homes and removing firearms. I mean, the thought is preposterous.
But you know what? The thought of it is preposterous, and people are very concerned about it. I mean, this whole idea of identifying gun owners in newspapers and chipping away at these gun rights and getting a registry. I mean, this guy McCarthy, the chief of the third largest police department in the nation, who works for Rahm Emanuel, who's so connected to the White House, is saying, you know what, we should be able to put a chip in your gun. Are you crazy?
You know, that's why the American people bristle at the thought of a national gun registry. And if the United States, the White House or anybody, would turn over the name of gun owners in the United States to a foreign nation, to me that would be an act of betrayal on the American people. If the Mexican government deserves anything, it's more facts surrounding, as you opened up with, Fast and Furious, where the United States of America funneled guns across the border into a sovereign nation, into the hands of drug lords, and now those guns are being used to kill Mexican citizens. They should be demanding more answers about that.
I agree with you, and I think that they should be angry with this administration for sending those guns in and not telling them about it, all right, because their people were murdered as well. But let me go to you, Stephen Halbrook. I mean, you're the constitutional expert here. In Mexico, lawmakers are actually considering asking the United States to provide a registry of all gun owners in the border states, you know, California, New Mexico, Arizona, and Texas. Their reasoning is claiming that it'll make tracing guns used in violent crimes easier. Talk to me.
Registration is prohibited by U.S. law. It's been for a long time. Our first law prohibiting registration was passed right before World War II because we saw the experience of Nazi Germany, Soviet Russia. Registration means confiscation. The Firearms Owners Protection Act, signed by President Reagan, prohibits registration. The background check system prohibits it because we don't want a system in our country where all the citizens are, their names and identities are given to the government. And can you imagine turning this over to the Mexicans? You've already got members of the Mexican police and military selling their guns to drug traffickers. What are they going to do next? Organize burglary rings to go into the border states?
Well, that is exactly
the argument.
Idea is preposterous. Here's where the guns are. Go get them. But Sheriff,
yes.
Let me go back to you. The McCarthy, you know, you've got 25 years. You're a homicide detective. You've been elected three times as sheriff. I mean, you've been around the block. You know the drill. Why would this police chief, he can't combat murders in Chicago. He's not succeeding. What's your message to him?
Well, he doesn't have any answers. For all the killing that's going on in Chicago right now. And when you don't have answers, you deflect. So he chose to blame law-abiding gun owners for all the carnage and bloodshed that's going on in Chicago. He needs to spend more time attacking criminal gang members instead of law-abiding gun owners. And he needs to give the people of Chicago a sense of confidence that he can get his arms around this thing. And right now, that does not exist. And as long as he goes on this tirade against law-abiding gun owners, we're going to continue to see the carnage that exists in the city of Chicago.
And it's very sad. All right, Sheriff Clark and Stephen Halbrook, thanks so much for being with us this evening.